All right, we have some breaking news to tell you about at this hour. The U.S. Coast Guard in New Orleans has confirmed that an offshore platform in the Gulf of Mexico has caught fire. We still have some details that are coming into the newsroom right now, but we do understand that at least four people have been injured. Three of those have been airlifted to West Jefferson Medical Center. And parish officials say the rig is not drilling at a deep water site like the Macondo well that blew out in 2010. But Jefferson Parish Councilman Chris Roberts says the platform is a shallow water platform in the Gulf near West Coast Blank Bay, south of New Iberia. As you can see here, you're looking at pictures right now coming into our newsroom of the fire, and you can see that the smoke is billowing into the air. We have Travis Mackle joining me now with a little bit more on this, and we know of a little bit of information on this, that this is an oil rig that's owned,
it's owned by a company. Black Elk Energy. It's a Houston-based company. They do have a New Orleans office. It's relatively new, formed in 2007. You can look at these pictures right here. That are coming into our newsroom. But Black Elk does have a New Orleans office. It was started by a handful of seasoned industry executives in the oil and natural gas industry. They're listed, just to throw some numbers at you, they rank 127 in the fastest growing energy companies, rated in 2012. Like I said, it's a Houston-based company. We have reached out to that company in Houston, and we are planning to go by their New Orleans office, obviously. They are dealing with this right now as you're looking at these pictures come in. But it's owned by Black Elk. Everybody, when these things happen, just like when the Deepwater Horizon happened, we all became familiar with BP, Transocean. Yeah. Who were the key players? Black Elk is obviously.
That's the big question right now, is if there's any oil spilling into the water. This comes just on the heels of this big announcement by BP that they're settling and they're going to pay $4.5 billion.
And if you remember, we all look back at history. When the Deepwater Horizon happened, the Coast Guard and emergency leaders said they didn't think there was going to be any threat, any imminent danger to the shoreline
initially.
Immediately. Mm-hmm. They were completely wrong with that. And obviously, it was a search and rescue, search and recovery, which is what's happening here now. CNBC, I know, as you just said, I believe, is confirming that two people dead on the platform and others have been airlifted. It's our understanding to West Jeff Medical Center, which is probably the top-tier emergency facility that these workers could be taken to. But if you compare this to the Deepwater Horizon, and hopefully it doesn't get to that level, it doesn't appear to be at that level, although it's very serious, that they didn't know about how much oil was leaking into the Gulf, if any. But that's the big question, is how much oil, if any, is leaking.
The cause, obviously, still under investigation, but obviously this fire, pretty massive in size, you can see by the thick black smoke there. And we do know that two people have been confirmed dead. This is according to the KHOU website out in Texas. They are reporting that two more people are missing after this fire. So right now we know that four people have been injured, at least three have been airlifted to a hospital in Jefferson Parish. And we know now that two people have died, and they are all workers who have been working on that platform. You can see it's just south of Grand Isle.
Right. If you look where it is, I mean, most people are familiar with this area. It's right there. Grand Isle, if you're looking at the TV screen, Grand Isle to your left, Venice, Louisiana, and Plaquemines Parish to your right. Much closer to the shoreline than the Deepwater Horizon was. Obviously, the Deepwater Horizon more southeast of where this explosion happened. And that could pose a threat if this is leaking oil. It's our understanding. I see there are three airlifted to West Jeff Medical Center on the West Bank. But the big question on top of the search and rescue will be how much oil is actually leaking, how much oil is spilling, if any, because you look at where this is, Sulla, and it's very close to areas like Venice, to southern Plaquemines Parish.
South of Plaquemines Parish.
Can they contain that? I got to imagine first responders will be responding immediately, not just for a search and rescue, but also to contain anything that could be leaking from this rig. It's our understanding it's owned by Black Elk, and it's not a deep water rig. That was the problem with the Deepwater Horizon, is that it was further out. It was a much more dangerous procedure, as they were mining oil, if you will, digging much deeper, going much further down. This is not a deep water rig. It's our understanding. Not that that makes it any better, but all the people who are watching this, who have been down to this area, if you've gone down to Grand Island, to Venice, you can see rigs like this in plain's eye view from the coastline. If you're standing there on, if you will, the beaches of Grand Isle or the sandy area of Grand Isle, you can see rigs like this out in the Gulf. And this one, based on the maps we're showing you, doesn't look like it's too far. So I got to imagine that the Coast Guard and emergency responders not only are performing search and rescue missions, but they're also trying to gauge how much oil, if any, is leaking.